It is the Double D's joining you on this segment. I'm going to introduce you to a good friend of mine. Her name is Danielle Watson. She is a TEDx speaker. She's an author of the book, Dear Self, I Love You. Keep going. Great title there. And she's also the creator and host of the Danielle Daily. Nice to have you on Arizona Daily, Meg.
Thank you, Diva. Glad to be here.
I'm so happy you're here. Now, this is so funny because we're talking today about dating after divorce, something I had never even thought about. And there's a lot of friends of mine who are divorced. Yeah. I saw your post on Facebook. You were living here. You moved back east. And I said, you got to fly in. You got to tell us all about this. So what is the dynamic now? Because technology has changed everything. How do you get people who have been married for 25, 30 years to adapt to finding love on an app?
Well, it's not easy if you have not come up with the internet generation and you're putting yourself back out there for the first time. Dating online and dating apps can be so intimidating. But the first thing to do is just recognize that you are a desirable person and there are people out there who are looking to date you. And the way that people date these days is online and using dating apps. Mm-hmm. Now, dating apps solve the problem of where do you find someone to date, but they created a bunch of other problems, like this is a really unnatural way to meet somebody and ask them out on a date. And so what I've done is I've created a formula called Grow, where I teach people how to use these dating apps and online dating so that they can actually meet someone to have a relationship with.
Because you want them to grow, especially with technology, because again, this is the avenue that we have to go down, unfortunately.
It is.
So let's talk about using these apps, because there's a lot of apps out there right now. So the number one thing that people have to do that sometimes people struggle with is the profile picture.
Yes, the profile picture. Mm-hmm. So when you put up your profile picture, you want to make sure that it is a close-up shot of your face.
Okay.
And really what people want to see is they want to look into your eyes, right? Oh. The old saying that the eyes are the windows to the soul. Right. Somebody wants to be able to look you in the eye just the way they would if they met you in real life. And that's the point of your profile, is really to allow somebody to start imagining themselves as part of your life and standing there next to you and what it would be like if they were to meet you in person.
Nice, I love that. So there are some tips because you want your profile to not only just have that great picture, but you also want it to have some things that speak volumes about you, but it's not too wordy. And that's where people get lost because no one wants to read a novel online. So what are some tips you would give them?
You're right. So first of all, ladies need to pay more attention to the photos they use because men are very visual and they're going to pay the most attention to the photos that you put up. Gentlemen need to think about what they put in their profile more than the ladies, because women want to read about you. But what you want to do when you put together your profile is share things that you want to share with the person that you would be dating. So common interests, that's the most important thing. A lot of people, the mistake they make is they put up a profile that is basically like a baseball card of their stats or a list of demands of things that they are looking for. And what you want to do is create a natural connection between the two of you by sharing common interests the way you would if you met somebody at a cocktail party.
Right, so do you speak about your kids, if your kids are grown and out of the house, do you mention that kind of stuff?
I get that question a lot. Okay. So it's really important, especially people who are dating after divorce. A lot of times they have families. And you do want to mention in your profile if you have children. And the best way to do that is to couple that statement with something that you like to do with your children.
Okay.
That lets people know what stage of life those kids are at.
Right, because you don't want them to assume that, oh, she's got kids. Are they little? Are they big? Are they graduated? Are they still at home?
Right.
Now, this is something that I hear all the time from people who are on dating sites, but they're younger. They're not dating after divorce.
Mm-hmm.
Pets. Especially, a lot of guys don't want to date a woman that has cats. Mm-hmm. Is that a bad thing to say if you have cats?
I think the most important thing is to have a policy of honesty.
Okay.
So if you have cats and you love your cat, you need to let people know that that is a part of your life so that they can self-select if that's something that they want to share with you.
Now, do you recommend certain sites for certain individuals? Because there are people that are over 50. There are some people who may unfortunately have never even used their phone outside of anything but using it as a phone.
Right.
So getting them to be on this app is a different process. So do you recommend certain sites that are a little bit more easier to navigate? Okay.
Yeah, so the easiest site that I have found and that I recommend is actually called Bumble. Oh. And it gives you a lot of options for photos, and it gives you a small amount of space to describe yourself. But there are many apps out there. There are Match.com, we have eHarmony, Tinder, OkCupid. There's Our Time for people dating after 50. And all you need to do is just go to either your Apple or your Android-based app store and search dating apps and just try them out. If you don't like them, they're easy to delete.
It's a lot of work out there, the beast of technology, but if you want to find someone that's compatible with you, just take Danielle Watson's tips and see if they work for you. Have fun, put up a great picture, and let the adventure begin, as they say in the dating world. We'll have more information on our website, aztv.com. Don't go anywhere. More of Arizona Daily Mix when we get back.